Jacob, appreciate you coming on this morning. I guess not morning, this is going to air tomorrow afternoon, but I guess just to start, man, this has been a magical run. It's been a long time coming for y'all. But I want to take you back a few years ago. November 8th, it's 2018. This is your sophomore season, first game of your sophomore season. I was a freshman at U of R. This was the first Richmond basketball game I ever watched. You guys lose to Longwood by 5 at home. Weeks later, you lose to Hampton by 20 at home. And you finish that year with 20 losses, your second year in a row with 20 losses. Let's not forget, too, that spring, there was a billboard calling for your coach's job. 2 years later, you guys start to turn it around. You're on the verge of an at-large berth. You haven't been in the tournament in 9 years, and COVID literally sends you packing from Brooklyn. And just a week ago, you were a sixth seed in the A-10 tournament. You trailed URI by 15 in the second half. This journey has been literally everything but easy for you guys. A lot of people have doubted you the whole way, have doubted your teammates. I myself have had doubts at times. What does this run show about your squad through all the adversity, and what has it meant to you personally?
Yeah, I mean, it's been incredible. I've said it before. It's obviously been a difficult journey for us. Everything wasn't always easy for us. You see a lot of teams like we came into this Iowa game thinking, I mean, they've been here before. Obviously they won their tournament, but they're accustomed to this. I mean, this is something that's new to us. We're excited for. But yeah, I mean, through the adversity, I mean, everybody goes through their own things individually. But as a collective group, I think this older group of guys, Grant, myself, Nick, Nate, Jordan, Sullivan, I mean, we've been through the ups and downs, through the trials and tribulations. It only makes, getting to where we are, and yesterday so much sweeter. At the end of the day, obviously you come back and that's your goal growing up, but you never understand what it feels like to achieve that or to really get there. So for us to get there with this group of guys who's had multiple 20 loss seasons, had a guy tear his ACL twice, you know what I mean, had people that doubted us and our coach and this program, it feels incredible, really. I mean, it truly, truly does feel great to climb over that mountain and just to be on top for a little bit.
Has there been a moment yet where it has hit you that, wow, I am playing in this. I did just beat Iowa, or is it almost, you're so locked in, you're blacked out. It's like it's another game. We're playing Iowa, and you're kind of just going through what you go through.
So when I first stepped out there for warmups, I tried to soak it all in. I talked to one of my close friends the night before and kind of just told me, once you get out there, man, just look down at your feet as soon as you step on the court and just, realize that this is the biggest stage of college basketball. This is where you want to be. There's no better place to be. And so that's what I did for warmups. Had a little bit of butterflies. Kind of quickly got over that and got acclimated. But for me, I kind of just get lost in the game. At the end of the day, it's win or go home. And you want to show everything that you can do at this stage. And that's what I went out there and tried to do.
Yeah, well, on the court, it certainly didn't look like you had butterflies. You had no problem getting it done yesterday. Kind of going back to this 5-game run, as you guys went through the A-10 tournament in DC, obviously that's, right in your backyard, just 2 hours from Richmond. And as that tournament moved on, we saw more and more red shirts fill up the stands. And that Sunday game against Davidson, right? That almost felt like a home game to some degree. And even yesterday, I felt like being in KeyBank Center, as much as a neutral site for a March Madness regional can be, that kind of felt like a home game. I almost felt like, there were a lot more Richmond fans there than Hawkeye fans. These fans have been craving it. It's been 11 years. This run's been very special for them, as it has for you. Can you just describe the energy of the fan base that they've traveled with you guys, and have you been able to feed off it at all through this run?
Yeah, no, I mean, I think the fans all year have been great. Particularly when we're at home at the Robin Center, you noticed it with the students. I think it was a like a winter break game, and it was a really good turnout. I mean, the students were great all year. But like you said, in DC, it was crazy, man. I think, obviously BCU probably had. I think that was the only time that I felt like fans may have been louder than us or may have outnumbered us. But the fans have been great, like you said yesterday. I mean, obviously we're the underdog, so you're gonna get some chance from Providence, from other people around, just kind of watching, being the underdog. But the fans have been great. The energy, the atmosphere, I mean, it's been incredible. Like you said, it's been you know, over a decade at Bruin for the fans to come out here and watch. So, you know, it's just been incredible. Like, we walked through the hotel yesterday and so many people I didn't know just saying congrats and stuff like that. I mean, it's just been, it's been unreal. Seriously, Spider Nation has been great.
When you guys have been at your best this year, I feel like it's when you guys have been playing loose and kind of not overthinking things. You know, yesterday against Iowa, I thought you guys looked like by far the more confident team, the more comfortable team, you know, maybe more so than you have all year. And I think that showed in the game. You guys really controlled the pace of that game, and that was played the style I think you guys would prefer to play. You know, Iowa had the expectations on them. Everyone was pegging them as a Final Four contender, right? You guys are coming off the magical Cinderella run. Do you think with all those things in mind that you guys were the looser team out there yesterday, and did that kind of play to your advantage in being able to control the pace of that game?
Yeah, no, most definitely. I think, you know, with myself being out there, I'm going to usually dictate the pace of the game. It's kind of just, you know, what I try to do. But yeah, we're definitely, you know, like I've been saying, we're confident. You know, I told the guys before we went out there, at the end of the day, they've got all the pressure on them. Right? We get to go out there and, you know what I mean, everything we do, you know, it's just because of us. Like, we're not trying to go out there and impress anybody. We don't have anybody that's supposed to be a lottery pick. We don't, you know what I mean, we don't need to get any one particular person the ball. We're just going out there playing for one another. You know what I mean? At the end of the day, we're just trying to have some fun. And that's what I think we did out there. Obviously, you know what I mean? We made some shots, but you know what I mean? I think when anytime anybody needs to shoot the ball, like, I'm telling Tyler, shoot the ball, Nick, shoot the ball, Matt, shoot the ball, Dre, shoot the ball, Grant, shoot the ball. Like, you get open shots, you got to take them. And, like, there's no pressure on any of these shots. Like, just shoot them.
Yeah.
And, you know, I think we played well yesterday. Obviously, we're going to be a confident group, but, you know what I mean, when we play free, we're pretty good.
Yeah. Can you just talk about the ability of such a plethora of guys to step up in big moments? You know, you guys obviously have a lot of big players. You've had your moments. Grant's had his moments, Nate's had his moments, Tyler's had his moments, multiple all-conference players, right? But sometimes, you know, in VCU, that was your game, right? Dayton was kind of Grant's game. Matt hit a shot against Davidson. Isaiah Wilson, big-time three-pointers. Like, that's a guy that really hasn't been able to shoot the ball a year. Hit a huge three. You know, what is it – and Nate yesterday, you know, Nate with the clutch and ones. What does it say about the way that so many different guys have been able to come up clutch in so many different moments?
You know, I think, one, that's probably because of our offense. You know, I think yesterday me and Tyler had it going pretty early. I think they probably made adjustments to that and kind of tried to lock us down and freed Nate. I mean, you know, I don't think I've ever seen Nate call for the ball as much as he did yesterday. You know, I mean, coming down the stretch, I felt like, you know, I mean, he thought that the guy couldn't guard him. And, you know, he showed that. But at the end of the day, it just shows that we're confident in one another. You know what I mean? We're playing for the guy to our left and right. We believe in one another. We've seen what we're capable of. I mean, at the end of the day, you know, Nathan Kale is in a 1,000-point score. You know, I mean, Tyler Burton is now in a 1,000-point score. Nick Sherrod's in a 1,000-point score. Grant, myself, are a 1,000-point score. So it's like, we got guys that can play, man. Like, we're not worried about the big moment. We're not worried about who's going to take the shot. As long as it's the right shot, you know, we're going to live with it.
Yeah. I know it's been a quick turnaround, but have you had a chance to scout Providence, and just initial thoughts on that scout?
Initially a little bit yesterday. I talked to the coaches about it. You know, just my bad. At the end of the day, you know, it's going to be another tough team. You know, they're a physical Big East team. They like to get the ball inside. They like to try to punk you, try and be tough. You know, but I think lately the 50-50 ball has been us. The jump balls have been us. We've been great. Usually, we've been pretty good on the backboard through this last five games. You know what I mean? You know, I think we've been a tough, gritty team, and, you know, can't expect anything less to change. So, you know, we got to lock in for them. At the end of the day, they're going to have to guard us as well. But, you know, our defense has been the key to this run we've been having, for sure.
Yeah. Well, Jacob, I know you're busy, so I just got one more for you, and I'll let you go. Big day. But you've obviously worn a lot of hats over the last several seasons. You know, you've always been able to shoot the ball. You've always been able to score. But, you know, for the last few years, it's more so, you know, you've been the steals guy. You've really ran the offense really well, and kind of you've scored when it's come to you. But you kind of try to run the offense and facilitate. But, you know, over these, not even these last five games, really these last 2 months, right, you've been this team's premier scorer. You've had that dog. You've taken the ball. You've wanted to get after it. And especially, you know, we've seen guys get cold in different games, and you've really been able to take over games like maybe we haven't even seen. You know, Chris Mooney said in the post-game press conference the other day, you know, when you guys take the floor, he feels like no one can guard you. Can you talk about, you know, your approach these past couple of months and being able to shoulder the offensive load, like kind of like a way we haven't really seen before?
Yeah, you know, I think offensively I was a lot more aggressive in conference play. You know, I kind of saw how things were going when I was trying to just facilitate. I don't think it worked out too well for us. But at the end of the day, I think we're a better team when I'm aggressive. I think when I'm looking to attack, it obviously puts a lot of pressure on the defense, and I think it allows me to get easy drop-offs to Grant or find Tyler on the wing. No matter what it is, you know, I think at the end of the day I'm going to make the right play. But if I can set the tone early, and try and get guys going rather than just kind of feel the game out, I think we're a lot better team. And, you know, Will was calling me playoff pill earlier. He was talking about our NIT run last year and then this last, you know, five games. So he was talking about my last seven games. But, you know, at the end of the day, I'm doing whatever it takes to win. And I think, you know, when I'm aggressive, we have a lot better chance to win. So, you know, I've always been able to score. I might not always try and score, but I think, you know, I mean, when I'm playing aggressive, we're better.
Yeah. Well, playoff pill. I know you got a big day today, so go get after it. Get your prep in, man. See you there tomorrow, and hopefully I'll be seeing you in Chicago next week.
All right, boss. Appreciate you.
Be good, man.